Hi, everybody. Welcome to Tony the Mole Adams YouTube channel. And we're back. We had a fortnight break a fortnight ago. We had a double episode last week. And now we're back to normal service, which is hard hitting news and gossip. And the chief, I don't want to. I know I was going to introduce him as Chief Gossip Monger. I'm not going to say that at all because it's all well-founded.
Getting hot here.
Well-founded and reliable information. Tony Adams, how are you?
Yeah, a bit melancholy today, Steve, as we were just discussing on air. I've just come back from the memorial service for the great Ian Heads, legendary journalist, was held at the Sydney Cricket Ground and very appropriate setting. We had some big names there: Brad Fittler, Mick Cronin, John Quayle, all sorts of league luminaries. And I worked out there was probably a million bylines there if you added up all the journos who turned up. So very nice service, but quite sad afterwards. We've lost a great man.
Yeah, I did work experience in my school holidays with Ian at Rugby League Week. Enormous influence on me when I started, and I guess one of the things living overseas is I really it's sad that I often can't go to these things. So I envy the fact you went, even though it probably hasn't put you in a great mood. But I wish I could have gone myself. Now we are here to promote journalism too. We're here to promote Tony's columns at Wide World of Sports NRL. And read the column through the links in the show description. That's what we're here to talk about. And don't forget to like and subscribe. And Tony, your lead item in your midweek scoops this week has got everyone talking. It's about the possibility of Michael Maguire returning to the Rabbits.
Yeah, that's right. And of course, Michael's well known to listeners in your part of the world, having had great success at Wigan. Then he came back and I described him as the only man alive to coach South Sydney to a premiership, famously 10 years ago this year, 2014. Then he got the punt in 2017, as happens in coaching, and now Souths are in a bit of a quandary. Jason DiMicco is basically a dead man walking. He probably bought himself a few more weeks with a gutsy performance with a bunch of injuries against Cronulla last weekend. Now, Michael Maguire, as we know, is a New South Wales Blues coach. So we're talking for next season. If DiMicco gets the heave-ho in the next few weeks, maybe David Ferner, who I spoke to today, he's suddenly come back to the Rabbitohs. He was an assistant coach. Then he went to Newcastle. Then he went to the Tigers. Now he's back at the Rabbitohs. So plenty of movement in the coaching ranks. But the word is there are a few contenders for this South job, Mal Meninga being one. I guess you'd have to say David Ferner another. John Morris, who's an ex-South reserves coach. And all of a sudden, Michael Maguire's name's come up, and it wouldn't be surprising if he gets back there. You never know.
Now, the next player you're going to discuss is hasn't got a club at the moment because he's left Hull following the sacking of Tony Smith last week. And there was a Hull fan on social media who obviously is a fan of wordplay and onomatopoeia, because his nickname for this guy is Sex Toy. His name is Tex Hoy. Tex Hoy, where is he hasn't got a club at the moment. Will he find one? Where's he off to?
Well, I think he's going to come back and look for a club, and he'd be the sort of player. He's a handy backup player. He can play fullback or 5/8. He played for the Knights from 2020 to 2022, sort of in and out of first grade, and he's the sort of player, much like Famunu Brown, who just picked up a deal with the Dragons. And maybe you can shed some light on this, Steve, because in the space of, 48 hours, we've had Tony Smith going, and now these two NRL imports. What's going on at LFC?
Well, I don't think they were super popular there. I think Tex Hoy's defence was called into question. I think New Brown was unhappy because, he's the current Kiwi test hooker, and he was playing in the halves for a team that was getting flogged every week. So I think the negotiations about Tex Hoy leaving were going on before Tony Smith was sacked. And I think probably New Brown said, well, you know, this isn't the guy who recruited me, and I'm not really happy, and I've got an opportunity back home. You know, compassionate grounds. We hear about that all the time. We heard about James Fisher Harris as we're recording this in the last few hours. Yes. So I think that's what has happened there. Speaking of the Dragons, Zach Lomax, his future is determined. It has been decided, in other words. His teammates aren't super upset about it. Is that what you reckon, Tony?
Yeah, that's right. And I don't normally like writing past like this, but a Dragons insider, shall we say, went out of his way to tell me and said to me, put it out there that he's not very popular with the coaching or the playing group. As he said, he won't be missed. So he's definitely a different cat, Lomax. Just the mere fact of what's happened in the last few weeks, he's been playing the best football of his career, yet he wants out. It's a very, very strange situation. And the Dragons have given him his wish. He'll be at Parramatta next season. Maybe there he'll be popular. Who knows?
And the final item of your Midweek Scoops column, which we encourage everybody to read, of course, is about a Queensland representative prop who is in New South Wales, I guess in Sydney, and isn't really happy where he is, looking to return to Queensland. There was a guy you mentioned who you also didn't name a few weeks ago. Different guy? Same guy?
Different guy, and... You sort of jumped the gun a bit. You've said he was a prop. He's not a prop, but he's a forward. So you're close.
The last guy was a prop. The last guy was a prop, right? Okay.
That's right. Yeah. Well, there you go. This one isn't a prop. So he's one of the biggest names in the NRL. He's a very good forward, but he hasn't settled in well at his current Sydney club. And he does have a get-out clause for next season. So it's one of these ones you can't name him because everyone will just deny it. But watch this space and remember where you heard it.
Tony had a bit of a coughing fit there, so I don't know if that's going to show up in the video or not. You were talking, so hopefully they're not going to hear that. It's been a pleasure, Tony. Enjoy your weekend of football. A lot happening on both sides of the world in rugby league. And everyone will be back with a new video in the middle of next week. We'll be right back.